girl Kiana Talented. If you are new to my channel, welcome. And if you're a returning OG, what is up? All right, so if you clicked on this video, you guys, you want to know how to match your foundation. You must be having trouble, you know, finding the perfect match. You must be having trouble, you know, understanding how to find a good match. Well, I am here to help you. I am here to kind of guide you. Just want to say that I am not a professional makeup artist. I am a makeup enthusiast, but I do have a lot of knowledge with makeup. I do have my cosmetology license, and when I was in cosmetology school, it was like a small portion where they went over, you know, makeup. It wasn't really nothing too big, but I do know a lot about makeup, and everything that I say in this video is just, you know, it's kind of things that I've learned on my own and things that, you know, I've just, knowledge I've gained over the years. I've been doing my makeup for about 3-4 years now, and I am very passionate about it, and I really love what I do, and baby, I'm popping, period. No, let me stop. But I'm just gonna give you guys some tips and tricks and things that, you know, I apply to, you know, how I do my makeup, because if you're not following me on Instagram, baby, at Kiana Talented, I'll be having some popping pictures. I'll be having some popping looks. Just saying. So make sure you follow me. Instagram will be down in the description box. But I'm just gonna give you guys some tips and just, you know, give you guys some basics that you should know in order to find the right foundation shade, how to pick up the right foundation shade, and just like things of that nature, okay? So I do have some notes of, you know, things I'm gonna talk about in this video. And then I also have some different shades of foundation. So I'll be able to actually show you guys, you know, what to do when you go into stores to pick a foundation. So I'm gonna actually break down things that you should know when choosing your foundation before I actually show you guys. So that's why your girl is barefaced, but baby, I look good, okay? Okay, let me stop. All right. So one of the things that you should know is, hold on, I gotta look. What are your skin concerns? Okay, so why exactly do you wanna wear makeup? Why exactly do you wanna wear foundation? Okay, so when I say skin concerns, I mean like, is your skin oily? Is your skin dry? Or do you have combination skin? So you need to figure that out before you, you know, drive to the store, walk to the store to even go pick out anything, because foundations cater to different things with, you know, different skin types. So just know what your, like, you know what your skin is like. So for me, just giving you guys an example, I have combination skin, but my skin is more so on the dry side. So it also depends on the seasons with me, you know? So during the summertime, my skin can be like, not necessarily oily, but my T-zone can get oily, and then the rest of my face is just normal. So that's what kind of makes me, you know, have combination skin. But then during the winter time, baby, I'm dry as hell, okay? Like, literally everything is dry. Like, my T-zone that used to be oily, damn near is dry now. So it just also depends on the season. So you need to figure out, you know, what season you're buying your foundation in, and figure out what your skin type is like. Number two is, what are your undertones? So I'm actually going to break this kind of, you know, I'm gonna break this foundation, you know, how to match your foundation, and just beginner tips into some different videos. And number two, undertones, is a whole video by itself. But just a little teensy bit about it is, your undertones, there's cool, neutral, and warm. You need to know what, you know, what your undertone is. Now, to figure out your undertone, you can look at your wrists and look at your veins. I can't exactly remember off the top of my head what is what, but I have blue, like I have bluish green veins. So my undertone is neutral, if I'm remembering correct. Like I said, let me just stop talking right here. That is going to be a separate video where, you know, I get everything together, and then I'll be able to break that down, because when it comes to undertones, and when it comes to picking foundations, some brands say that this is this undertone in this foundation, but then in another brand, you can be a different undertone. So it's like completely, like, it's long, okay? So I'm gonna dedicate another video to that, because I don't want this one to be a little lengthy. I don't want it to be too lengthy. So yeah, another video will be coming soon about that. But different undertones is cool, neutral, and warm. Me, I consider myself to be, like I said, like a neutral undertone, but like when I shop for foundations, I go for a warmer undertone, if that makes sense. I'll explain when I show you guys the different undertones with the foundations, but yeah, know your undertone. That will help you pick out your foundation as well. Number three is, what type of coverage do you want with your foundation? Now, when it comes to coverages of foundation, there are, you know, different things for the different type of coverages you want. You have a light coverage, you have a medium, and you have full coverage foundations. Then you also have tinted moisturizers, BB creams, powder foundations. So it just, you know, it all depends on what type of look you're going for, what type of coverage you're going for. Now, if you're OG to my channel, you know that I am a full coverage type of girl. So I buy foundations that are full coverage or medium to buildable, like medium to full coverage foundations, because I have discoloration on my face, I have dark scarring, and when I wear makeup, I want that to be covered. Now, don't get it twisted, I am very, you know, confident in how I look with my natural skin. It's just when I wear makeup, I want to look glam, I want to look popping. So what is the point of having my blemishes pop through, you feel me? Like, so it just all depends, you feel me? So knowing what kind of coverage you want to get is going to help you pick out a foundation. Number four, you can customize the shade that you want. So say you go buy a foundation and you just can't find your perfect match. Now let me tell you guys, 9 times out of 10, when you're a person of color, a woman of color, you are not going to find one foundation that matches you perfectly. You're not. Point blank period, you're not. Like, yeah, nowadays there's like 40 to 50 shades of foundation, but those like still don't match, you feel me? Like with Fenty foundation, I have to actually mix 2 shades to get the perfect shade I want, you know? And they have what, like 40 shades of foundation, but yet I still have to mix a foundation. And as you guys can see, I'm not even that dark, you feel me? I've actually gotten a really, really light because I haven't been getting a lot of sun, so, you know, I haven't tanned or whatever, but I'm not that dark and I have to mix foundation. So, you know, that should tell you something. So, it's okay to have to buy 2 foundations or, you know, mixing things to get your perfect shade. It just, if you want to be perfect, that's what you gotta do. So, yeah, don't beat yourself up or, you know, don't feel pressure because you're like, oh my gosh, I can't find a perfect match. And then also when it comes to foundations is just something that evens out your skin tone. When it comes to makeup, you want to like highlight, contour, bronze and things like that to actually bring your face together, because if you just use a foundation, you're going to look like a flat pancake. You're not going to have any dimension. You're not going to have any shadow going on with your face. And you don't want to look like a pancake, do you? Even though pancakes are good, you don't want to look like a pancake, okay? So, yeah. Customizing a foundation shade, there is nothing wrong with it. And number 5 is, I put down go lighter or go darker, but for me, this is just a personal preference, when I foundation shop, I go darker because when I conceal and highlight my face, I go lighter with my concealer so it evens it out. But if you're a person that doesn't really want to highlight and do all of that extra color correcting, you just want a foundation and just something to, you know, even out your skin tone, I would recommend going lighter because you can always, you know, bring your face back with bronzing. So it depends on what you want to do, you feel me? Like, it just depends on how much work you want to do. So those are just my little tips on, you know, what to think about when you're going to go foundation shop. So you guys, I am about to explain to you guys how I actually foundation shop, now that we got the little what you need to know in order to foundation shop out the way. So what I like to do is I like to wear a tank top or, you know, a little bidou, something that actually, you know, reveals my chest. And if you're going shopping during the winter time, wear a V-neck, wear something that you'll be able to swatch in your neck. Now for me, I like to, you know, match my foundation to my chest, like I mentioned earlier. And I also do my jawline, but for the most part, I want my face and my chest to match. I don't really match to my neck because my neck has a shadow on it from, you know, my face. And it's darker than my face, so I don't want to match my foundation to my neck. If you want to match your foundation to your neck, do you, boo, okay? Now, I know there are a lot of people that, you know, they match their foundation to their chest, but they also do bring foundation down to the neck. Baby, I just don't got time to be ruining shirts with foundation. Have you ever got foundation on your clothes? Have you? No. Okay, so I just don't like ruining clothes trying to blend my foundation down to my neck. I just don't have the patience. So I just match to my chest. So the next thing you want to do is have a clean face. Go foundation shopping with a bare face, okay? Do not go in there with makeup on. That's going to defeat the purpose of you trying to match your foundation. Like, how are you supposed to match foundation if you got foundation on? Like, you see where I'm going? Okay. So I go in there with a bare face. If you want to, you know, look a little glam, do your eyebrows, put on some lashes, call it a day. You are going to, you know, get your foundation so that you'll be able to look poppy. You feel me? So I go in there with a bare face and I do give myself time, you know, because when I like to foundation shop, I like to do a swatch and then let the foundation oxidize, let it do its little magic. Let me see what it's going to do before I actually be like, okay, swatch. Oh, it looks good. Let me go cash out. No, you need to swatch, walk around the store, maybe even leave the store, let it, you know, touch some air, some other air than what's in there. You need to see what the foundation looks like in different lighting, because I'm telling you, makeup stores like Ulta and Sephora, mainly Sephora though, they have studio lights all in the store. So studio lights, I don't know if you guys know, but they wash you out. They wash you out. They wash all your nice melanin, all your nice color out your skin. So you want to, you know, be able to leave the store for a second, see how the foundation is, you know, applying on your chest or applying to your face, like, you know, see what it looks like in different lighting. That is just what I like to do. So anytime I've ever went makeup shopping, I've always given myself, you know, an hour or maybe 2 hours just so I can be able to, you know, figure out what, you know, what shade is the right shade for me. Also, when I go foundation shopping, I am not afraid to ask for samples to take home, because just because you swatch it and you let it sit for a minute, okay, when you get home and you're in different lighting, maybe that foundation is just not sitting with you right, like sitting right with you anymore. Like, maybe when you went foundation shopping, you was a little bit sleepy, so your eyes wasn't acting a little correct and stuff like that. So just give yourself some time. Don't be afraid to ask for samples. Also, if you don't know what you're doing, don't be afraid to ask for help either. Like, just because you're getting this information from me, don't feel like you gotta go in a makeup store and be like, oh, I know what I'm doing. No, don't do that. They're there to help you. Now, granted, everybody that, you know, works in a makeup store, some of them don't know what they're doing. Some of them, you know, some people get hired just because they know somebody. Some people are just there because they just don't got shit else to do. So, you know, granted, some people don't know exactly what they're talking about. And especially when you're a woman of color, a person of color, and you're interacting with, you know, somebody that's not the same skin complexion as you, and you're just like, well, how are you supposed to help me out? Like, you don't know what I'm going through. Like, you got foundations that match you, you know? So don't be afraid, you know, sometimes to ask for help from, you know, people in the store. Like, when I've went shopping before for foundation, I've swatched it on my chest, I've swatched it on my face, and I've asked another person, like, what do you think about this? Does this look like it blends in with me? Like, you know, because at the end of the day, other people are going to be seeing you. So, you know, don't be afraid to ask for opinions from people in makeup stores when shopping. Like, you know, sometimes they be wanting to do the same thing, they just don't be having the guts to ask. So if you need to, don't be afraid to ask for help. Like, ain't nothing wrong with asking for help. So I think I got everything out that I wanted to say. I do have some drugstore products here that I'm gonna swatch on my chest, just so you guys can see what I mean by, like, swatching the foundation, like how to swatch it, I guess I should say. Yeah, that's pretty much what I'm saying, like how to swatch foundation. So I am gonna do the side of my face and I'm gonna do my chest for you guys so you guys can see what I mean. So I do have three foundations right here. These are the Maybelline Super Stay foundations. This is my holy grail foundation, you guys. Like, I absolutely love this foundation so freaking much. Now the shade I use on a regular, the shade that, you know, I feel is, you know, best for me, it's not perfect. It is not perfect. No way, shape, or form. But the shade that I like to work with is the 360 Mocha. I just feel like the shade, just, it does it for me, you know? I just feel like it works for me. And I also have 362 Truffle. This shade is just a little too light for me, but it is workable. It is definitely workable, but I don't really grab for it that much because I have 360 Mocha, which I'm very comfortable with. And then I also bought 370 Deep Bronze. I bought this because I thought that, you know, my skin was darker than what it was. But when I got home and applied this all over my face, my babe was like, why you look like you just got beat up all over? So I'm just gonna show you guys three different swatches of this foundation, like, just so you guys can get a sense of what I mean. I do wear high-end foundations, but I just really haven't had the need to, you know, go buy them because drugstore foundations are freaking bomb right now. For the price, you get the same amount that you would get if you was to buy a high-end. Like, I'm gonna go with drugstore. So this is a 360 Deep Bronze. So I am gonna swatch it on my face and I'm gonna swatch it on my chest because you could swatch a foundation on your face and it may look like it match just like this one because your face could like have hyperpigmentation. You guys can't even see that. But I actually do have this foundation on. That's crazy. So this foundation looks really freaking awesome on my face, but when it oxidizes, it looks extremely dark. Now I'm also gonna swatch on my chest so you guys can see what it's looking like on my chest, and it's just gonna amaze you guys like how crazy it can like just be. So because I have hyperpigmentation, I have dark scarring, this foundation is looking like it matches my face really, really good. But in reality, it is really dark and I would not be able to get away with this because if I was to go out in public and I was to wear a shirt like this, people would be looking at me like, girl, you don't match. Y'all see my baby hairs I tried to do? They look a little eh. But anyways, so I have this foundation on my chest and then I also have it on my jawline and a little bit up to my cheek. Now I did blend it out just a tiny bit and this is blending into my freaking face really, really well. But as you guys can see on my chest, it looks really dark. It's just what happens when you are trying to match your foundation. And this is why I say I like to match my foundation to my chest, because I'd rather my chest and my face match instead of you do just my face matching. Now I'm going in with 362. This is Truffle. Now the undertone for Truffle, let me move my necklace. So the undertone for Truffle, so this is a really, I don't wanna say neutral, but it is giving me neutral cool vibes right now. And like I said, you guys, I am making a separate video to go more into detail about that so you guys can understand, you know, how to find your undertone and how to look at, like, look for an undertone in a foundation. But this is giving me cool neutral vibes, you feel me? So the next foundation is 362 Truffle. This foundation, I'm swatching on my chest first. This foundation, like I said, I can actually use this foundation if I wanted to because it's not a bad match. I just don't like it. When it oxidizes down, it just looks crazy. So that is what this looks like blended out on my face. My hair is just getting in the way. So that is what a 362 Truffle is looking like. So applied to my face, it looks like it would be a good match. You feel me? Like, it is matching, you know, the center of my face and it's canceling out my dark spots. But when you look at my chest, it just oxidizing down, it just is, it's a little bit too dark. Like, you know, it's just darker than what I would want it to be. and that is the reason why I don't really pick it up too often, but blended on my face, it looks really good. But as I keep saying, you guys, I like my foundation to match my chest. Now, I don't know about you, but I would want my foundation to match my chest because, you know, I don't know. I just want my foundation to match my chest. Like, I don't really know what else to say. But that is what this is looking like on my face. So this is 370. This is 362 Mocha. And these shades are the shades one after another. So isn't that crazy? Like the big jump in between. Like I feel like they should have like a middle shade in between 362 and 370. Like where's 364, 366? Like where is that shade at, Maybelline? Might have to write Maybelline. Now, the shade that I use on a regular, the shade that I use in like all my videos is 360 Mocha. Now, this shade, you guys are probably going to be like, Key, that shade is too orange and it just, what are you doing? So for me, I like this shade because when I go in and contour and bronze, and when I highlight my face, it just looks really, really good with my skin. It just does. And then it being swatched on my chest, I just feel like it's the best match. Like, I just like it. Like, I really do. Like, it does give me orange vibes, but it's not too bad. I like to look tan. I like to look a little bit warmer than what I am. So this foundation is just really bomb. So this foundation is on the warm side. This one is giving me neutral vibes. So warm, neutral, cool. Okay, there we go. I didn't even think about that. Oh, I got this foundation in my freaking nail and it's not coming out. Like, don't it look like boo-boo? Got boo-boo in my nail. So to kind of give you guys an understanding of the undertones of foundations, this is considered a warm tone foundation. This will be considered a neutral, and this would be considered a cool. So do you guys kind of follow? Comment down below and let me know if you guys are following what I'm saying. If you're a beginner, I know if you're like an OG and you already know what you're doing in makeup, you probably understand what I'm saying. But if you're a beginner, let me know down below if you understand what I mean. And then looking on my face, let me move my earring out the way. Looking at my face, this one, it looks really good. 362 is actually not looking that bad. Might have to start using this a little bit more. But 362 on my face looks good, but 362 on my chest, it just is too dark. And I don't necessarily like it. That's crazy. But when I go, if I was to contour and highlight, it may look actually good. I might have to use it just because. But I hope you guys can see what I mean when, you know, it comes to swatching a foundation. Definitely swatching your chest. Go in different lighting. It actually is daytime. I could go outside and show you guys like what it would look like outside, but the way my legs is set up, I might save that for a different video. I'll probably show you guys in a different video, like, you know, comparing what it looks like in studio lighting and daylight. That's what I'm gonna do that for you guys. I'm gonna show you guys what makeup looks like in daylight and what it looks like in studio light. So I definitely will have a video. That's actually very, very smart to do. I ain't seen nobody on YouTube do that either. Don't be trying to steal my idea, period, because I fight you. But yeah, you guys, that is pretty much how I match my foundations. I hope you guys were able to understand and follow me throughout this video. I know I was kind of a little bit over the place, but if you know me, I'm a little kooky, I'm a little crazy. And so you guys, I hope this video explained to you how I pick out my foundation shade. I hope it helps you pick out your foundation shade. I hope it was easy to follow. Definitely let me know down below if I need to explain it a little bit more, if I need to go more into detail, so then I can know for the next video, because like I said, this is going to be a beginner friendly series on, you know, how to pick out makeup and, you know, how to do makeup as a beginner. I've been wanting to do this like serious for the longest. I know when I first started my channel, I did like a, you know, what a beginner should have in their makeup kit type of video, and like that was the type of route I was going with my channel. So I'm happy to actually, you know, have more knowledge and understand makeup more so that I can help you guys. Also, I am a beginner myself still. I still consider myself a beginner. Like, I still have so much more to learn, but we are on this journey together. So comment down below, let me know if you guys understood what I was saying. Comment down below any questions you have, or DM me once again if you know want to talk in private. And that is pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you're not, hold on girl, what you doing? If you are not part of the crew, I'm gonna need you to hit the subscribe button and turn on your post notifications so you will get notified every single time your girl posts a video. And also, before we close out, I know I keep talking, thank you once again for 3K supporters. It means the freaking world to me. And next up, 4K, and your girl is out. Peace.